I want to eat the intestine with a bowl of rice. Because that's what I used to eat when I was a kid.
Hi everybody, tonight I'm at the other side of Harbor Bridge and we are creating all the videos introducing some of our amazing restaurant customers. And tonight I'm going to introduce one of the Japanese yakiniku restaurant in Crow's Nest. So let's go inside and find out what's happening inside, okay? This is Vincent. Vincent is the owner of this restaurant. So Vincent, today, can you tell our viewers why you started this restaurant, when you started, and what's special about this restaurant?
Okay, yeah. The reason why I organized this restaurant, because I've been seeing so many Japanese yakiniku barbecue restaurants opening in Sydney area, but none of them this kind of a traditional, like for example, we are doing the very traditional Japanese charcoal street barbecue. Because why is a kind of street style? Because charcoal. Many restaurants use the gas. We are using the charcoal for more flavor in the barbecue.
Why this restaurant is famous for is like a secret recipe of like yakiniku sauce. Some chefs taste like a little bit sweet. Is that sort of like a kind of special recipe?
Oh yes. I think the most of the yakiniku sauce pretty much similar. Soy sauce, mirin, Japanese cooking wine, and the sugar. And we have our own homemade sauce recipe. Of course the recipe cannot be shared online, otherwise every restaurant can be kashiwa. The meat is very juicy. We order the wagyu from Osawa. The quality is very good. That's why we choose very light sauce for seasoning. So you won't change the meat original flavor too much. And this recipe has been focused on basic principle recipe for over 10 years since we opened. Just to keep update, keep changing the flavor, make it more better. This is our chef, Dira-san. And Dira-san, this is a junior.
Yeah, we know each other like last 10 years. Because Dira-san, he used to work for one of the biggest Japanese restaurants. So, we know each other like last 10 years.
No, 15 years.
15 years?
Even longer than me.
So that's why we know each other. Okay, so can you let us, our viewers know what's special for tonight?
Okay. When customer dining to our shop, basically they order salted sauce first, which is ox tongue, pork jaw meat, chicken soup for chicken tatty. So this is ox tongue.
Yeah, very thick.
Very thick plus very tender.
Yeah, very tender.
It's the way we keep our tongue. Very few restaurants does that.
Well, most of the Japanese restaurants they don't fry that thick.
Yeah,
I think our chef has his own concept. This is all hand cutting by our chef, and most restaurants that you see, there's only slice machine do that. So this is a very hard job for the chef.
Yeah, especially most of the customers come to Oxfam. It's unique.
I really want to try that the pan.
Oh, please.
Yeah.
Yes,
the
tongue is very
thick. Do I need to dip in that sauce?
I want you to try without dipping sauce first, so you can feel it. So you will know.
Good.
This is done.
Very thick. So you guys, try this tongue. Okay? This is a really good body. Try this.
Yes, try the sauce. Try
Yeah. It's the momi dare. It's really good.
This one of our signature dish. It's wagyu sashimi.
It's a yuke, right?
Yuke.
This sashimi? Well, do I mix up? Or?
Yes.
It's more like yuke, right?
Yes.
Egg yolk, good combination. I haven't had a yuke for a long time. Good, yuke is good. And the fresh. Guys, you should try it. Right?
That's soy sauce base. Mm-hmm. For example, this is wagyu beef rib, chicken thigh fillet, pork rib, hellish pork rib. Inside is cut. We call it finger steak, which is very popular too.
Okay, the best one is this one.
Ah, beef rib. Beef rib is customer feedback is just you just say one word, it's amazing. Once you cook, you just melt in your mouth.
Let's have a try. Adina-san. Yeah. Where should we should start?
Oh, please start with Scott.
Scott, okay. Yes, both. It's done.
Yeah,
I'll try. Do I need to put in the dipping sauce?
Yes.
Okay.
Itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu.
Oh, it's that sauce. Very nice.
That's why I said, you know, Vincent, some chef talking about this special yakiniku sauce.
Yeah.
Like, this is a little bit sweet so that the people, you know, like this sauce.
But we figure out, not all of the local people, they like the original taste. They like more sweet. That's why we put a little bit more sugar and even some sweet fruit inside the sauce. That's why make the sauce very match with barbecue, especially some fatty part because you have a fruit. Yeah. So you won't feel too fatty when you bite and melt in mouth perfectly.
With a special, where the special recipe or sauce coming from, Dida-san?
Sorry?
Where the idea coming from? Stealing somebody else? No?
I wouldn't say that.
What's next? Dida-san bring that intestine?
Yeah, something some special menu.
Something
yeah,
special.
Barbecue. Special.
Okay, so this is the intestine, right?
Yeah. Normally we do with miso sauce, or homemade miso sauce. Mm.
We should start.
Let's start, yes.
Guys, this is the big, large intestine. It's causing fire food.
Good job.
It's more like back in Japan, this thing.
Orange no flavor.
Because the intestines, really, we have a full of meat. Why people try intestines? Something unique. Especially the people been to Japan, traveling to Japan, go snow skiing, whatever. You go to some of the cheap yakiniku restaurants and the full of smoke something. Then you can try this kind of all different kind of intestines. Or you know, kind of like a internal organ. So, but you can try a little bit here in Sydney. Okay.
Okay. Thank you very much, Otawa-san, and thank you very much, guys. And you can always check the social media and the Facebook, Instagram about our restaurant Kashiwa. We provide the traditional street charcoal barbecue. And our chef, like I say, he's very good, and he always go to the market to pick up the best quality of the best parts, you know. The lunch menu is must to try. It's suitable for different parties. Okay, we have a different choice. You build your own style. Okay, thank you very much, guys. Yeah, please come to try. Kashiwa.
Yeah.
Okay, so tonight we are showing the Kashiwa Japanese Yakiniku restaurant, and I would give 3 points. You should try this restaurant one day. And one thing is, this restaurant is really more like a traditional Japanese affordable yakiniku restaurant. As I said before, if you have been to Japan, and this restaurant reminds you of the your experience of something cheap yakiniku restaurant in Japan. So if you're missing that part, you should come to this restaurant. Okay. Second thing is, most of the Japanese yakiniku restaurants, they have a buffet style, or you can eat. But this restaurant still doing all the a la carte. You can order each dish, like a big, the famous one, Wagyu ribs and Wagyu harami and tan. You should try tans. Third thing is, you can come to this restaurant with a family, husband, wife, and 2 kids. Still, you can, you know, fill up your stomach under $100. You know, you can enjoy authentic Japanese yakiniku experience here. Under $100 is still really good value. So those 3 things you should try, come over. And as I said before, booking is essential, always crowding. So guys, you should book a table first, especially weekend. One day you should come, okay? And also check our social media, especially this YouTube channel. And also we will create more new exciting deal on our website. Please check as well. Thank you for watching today. See you soon.